our way to a TA to park, and for some reason, I'm not getting the information for my next load yet.
We are going to make a video right now, okay. Me and you. Okay? Say hi, YouTube.
To explain to you guys my morning this morning. By all means, it has not been the worst morning I've ever had, but it wasn't the best morning that I've ever had. It seemed that everything was just working out slowly. Like, nothing was progressing. Nothing was moving forward as fast as it should be for my liking. And, oh, Rob, that's completely insane. Like, you were so, like, self-centered or whatever, and it's not that. When I put in a message in the Qualcomm to receive something, it's a computer-generated message that's sent back. It's not anybody at the dispatch office that's typing these things up. It's a Qualcomm generator. QPGMR stands for Qualcomm Programmer, okay? And that's what the Qualcomm says it's sent by. Sent by QPGMR, Qualcomm Programmer. So anyways, this morning, starting out, when I dropped off at the distribution center, it took them 2.5 hours to unload my trailer. Kind of sucks, because I was hoping I could get unloaded and get down the road and get this load and get down the road and yada, yada, yada. When they finally got me unloaded, 2.5 hours later, I pick up my trailer and I send in my message from my Qualcomm, because they have me on a pre-plan. I send the message in stating, I'm empty. And then typically what happens after that is I immediately get a message saying load acknowledgement. Like, you acknowledge that you have this load. Yes. And then I just put in my trailer, boop, 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 send it. And then immediately after that, I get all the information and I get my dispatch. Nothing. Nothing happened. So I went ahead and drove up to the TA, which was like 9 miles. I got a hold of somebody. I had told him what was going on. Hey, I need a number that starts with this number. He says, sure, here it is. Take that number, I give it to her, she gives me the paperwork, I go and get my trailer. I drop my trailer, pick up my trailer, I am about to leave. I get my paperwork, I send in my form saying, you know, I'm ready to roll. I get my dispatch immediately, so whatever was broken, now fixed, thank you. And then I go up to the pilot, and I go and fuel, and then I go and weigh. When I'm pushing the button to get weighed,
setting up our new printer.
I swear. It's like everything's running slow today. You guys saw, she says, we're actually putting in our new printer, so I'll be right with you. I just didn't say anything, because at this point in time, I was like, really? Is everything just gonna not work for me today? So, and then I get weighed, I go inside, and while I'm walking inside, I'm like thinking to myself, my tandems are going to be overweight, I know it, my tandems are going to be overweight, it's going to be insane, I'm going to have to adjust it, I'm going to have to go re-weigh, I won't be able to get down the road, and I stopped, I took a breath, and I went, you know what, as of this point, you need to make your day better, Rob, stop letting it make the worst of you. Just make it better.
I don't think I could have gotten this any closer. I didn't adjust nothing. This is just pure freaking luck. 3460, 3440, 11440. That is pure luck. Let's go.
It's up to you to make it better. So I took a breath, walked inside, spoke to the cashier. Hey, I'm here for my scale ticket. Got my scale ticket. Matter of fact, this is the closest that I've ever been to getting it perfect. I couldn't, if I move a pin one way or another, it's gonna be off 250 pounds. There's no possible way that I could have gotten it any closer inside the trailer. The trailer was sealed. So luck has started to flip itself around. And I'm cruising down the road, and everything is going great. I'm up, I'm awake, I'm ready to roll, I'm going, and knock on wood, traffic has not been bad. I've already been through Toledo, I'm on my way to Cleveland, gotta go through Cleveland, 15 miles away from it, as a matter of fact. Then I'm gonna head down toward Pittsburgh, then I'm gonna head my way down toward Harrisburg. And then I'm gonna go take a break. Well, actually, I don't even know if I'm gonna make it to Pittsburgh. I might stop in Pittsburgh and take a break, stop in Pittsburgh, but I don't know. I don't know if there's any truck stops. I haven't even decided where I'm gonna stop. I haven't even looked. So, whatever. Anyways, I just wanted to share that with you.